Hello everyone, welcome to my channel Learning Electronics. In this video we are going to learn about input characteristics of common emitter configuration. We have seen in the previous classes about what is common emitter connection. So before starting the characteristics, please subscribe my channel and also press the bell icon so that you can get more updated videos from here. So let us start the topic, common emitter connection input characteristics. We study these characteristics during active mode of operation. What is active mode of operation? This is NPN transistor. For active mode of operation, we connect the input circuit in forward bias and the output circuit in reverse bias condition as shown in the figure. What is input characteristics in transistor? Input characteristics in transistor is the curve between input current and input voltage keeping output voltage constant. So in case of common emitter connection, the input characteristics is the curve between input current, that is base current IB, and input voltage, that is base to emitter voltage VBE, at constant output voltage, that is collector to emitter voltage VCE. These characteristics are drawn by considering NPN transistor. So here we have taken base to emitter voltage VBE, that is input voltage, in x-axis and input current, that is base current IB, in microampere in y-axis, and the different curves are drawn at different values of output voltage, which is collector to emitter voltage as shown in the figure. So these characteristics can be used to determine input resistance RI. This input resistance RI in case of common emitter configuration is equal to the ratio of the change in base to emitter voltage to change in base current. So for finding this input characteristics, the input voltage VB is increased in small steps of 0.1 volt and output voltage VCE is kept constant at 1 volt and different values of base current is recorded. So from the diagram we can say that below this point, which is called as knee voltage, the base current is approximately equal to 0. This happens because the barrier potential at the emitter base junction does not allow the majority charge carriers to flow through the junction. Thus, emitter current becomes zero, making the base recombination current IB is also equal to zero. Therefore, the base current does not flow when the voltage, that is base to emitter voltage, is below this knee voltage. This knee voltage is equal to 0.1 volt for germanium transistor and it is equal to 0.5 volt for silicon transistors. But after this knee voltage, base current starts increasing with base to emitter voltage VB, and the curve obtained is same as the forward characteristics of PN junction diode as shown in the figure. But the base current IB does not increase as rapidly as emitter current in case of common base connection, as we have seen in the previous classes. So due to this, the input resistance in common emitter configuration is higher than the input resistance in case of common base connection. So as you can see here, we have drawn the curves at different values of output voltage VC for 1 volt, 5 volt and 10 volt. And we can see that as VC is increasing above 1 volt, the curve is shifting downwards. This happens because as collector to emitter voltage increases, the depletion layer width at at the collector base junction also increases, which decreases the effective base width, and this in turn reduces the base recombination current IB. So because of this, the curve is shifting downwards with increase in collector to emitter voltage. This is depletion layer at the collector base junction. So we have studied before also that the input resistance is the ratio of change in base to emitter voltage to change in base current, keeping collector to emitter voltage constant. Since with the increased width of the base to emitter voltage, the base current increases less rapidly, the input resistance in the common emitter connection is higher than the input resistance in the common base connection, as we have discussed before also. So that's all for this lecture. Thank you very much for watching, and please do subscribe my channel for more updates.